Hello, everybody. Welcome to a Jellyfish ON presentation webinar on display marketing at times of crisis, a response to COVID-19. Just to introduce you to myself, I am Thomas Ives. I work in our UK offices across Europe and North America. I'm a senior display director at Jellyfish, which means my role is a bit of everything to do with display and programmatic marketing. Before we get going today as well, we'd like to help you out at Jellyfish if we can. So the link's on the screen here for if you'd like to get in touch with us about anything that you've seen in today's webinar. We'll also be hosting a Q&A session as well. And if you want to ask a question at any point, there is a panel on the side of your screen where you can ask questions. And what we'll do is we'll do our best at the end of this session. My colleagues and I will read out the questions and we'll go through and get you some answers. Or if we need to go away and get more information or take the conversation offline, we will. So going back to the topic of today's webinar, COVID-19, this was something that's obviously taken the marketing world and the rest of the world by shock, really. We weren't planning for this earlier in the year. And then it became apparent that this was going to change everything that we were going to do in our daily lives. Jellyfish, we then had to ask ourselves, what will be the impact from COVID-19? And in the display department, we chose to ask ourselves three different questions. The first of which is, what has this done to inventory levels and prices? So is this changing the way that people are being available to be advertised to? Is it going to change consumption and shopping behaviors of people when they're online? And the final question really is, how can we continue to be successful in our marketing online? So first of all, one thing to say is various countries have gone into lockdown at different times, but it definitely has changed the inventory landscape. The first thing that we did as a display team was go away and look at what the changes have been in inventory. So we looked at major markets across Europe and the US as well to see if there are any trends in available impressions that could be purchased. If you look at around the mid-March date, we really do start to see this is when inventory levels started to change. So as you can see at the start of March and the end of February, this was about this normal level. And then you see this really steep incline. What we found out that this, unsurprisingly, was tied to when lockdown measures were put in place or there were serious developments in terms of the disease. So if we take Spain, for example, here, schools closed on the 9th of March, and then you see a steep increase in the available inventory. And then we see quarantine in force and another increase again as more people are locked away in their homes. Again, if we look at Denmark here, we can see a similar story. So here, reported cases start to rise early in March, and then social distancing is enforced a few days later. And again, we see it increase and start to level off as the new norm of life starts to take place. But then further than this, we start to ask ourselves, what really has changed in terms of CPMs, the cost of buying this inventory? So if we have a look at the United States as an example here, we can again see the same trend. There was the European travel ban, and then the emergency national emergency declaration, which saw a massive increase in inventory and then a big decrease in CPM. So CPMs went down by about 40%, inventory up by 60%. Saw the same thing here in Europe as well, where CPMs in Germany, I think is the other example, dropped by 30% and inventory was up 38%. And like, the inventory does fluctuate depending on the vertical, but this is, you know, a very broad look at that. So why are the CPMs decreasing? Well, there's three things that are happening here, really. There's inventory in abundance due to the amount of people who are going online, from that being extra entertainment, work from home, entertaining their kids, you name it, shopping online, whatever it may be, there's more people online. Secondly, we found advertisers started to pull back their activity at this time, so there was less people after this inventory, which then meant that there was less competition in auctions. This would then mean that there's less pressure and the CPM prices start to form. And what we've seen as well is every single category has seen a massive increase in impressions. Unsurprisingly, health has got the biggest increase. That's up above 400%. So high, in fact, that we couldn't even fit it on the graph because it made everything else look really small. But we still see on all the other categories an increase in impressions, even on things like sport, which will have been stopped in many countries, and even things such as travel, which has been reduced. And again, with things like real estate as well. So the inventory is increasing on those, even though these activities have been curtailed. And now, if we want to compare that as well to the amount of impressions that are available, this tells another slightly different story as well. Here we see the likes of artists and entertainment, the fourth biggest growth here, and news, which is way down the list at 66% growth. But as you can see, the most amount of impressions are now available in arts and entertainment and news for fairly obvious reasons. People wanting to entertain themselves, now most of their outdoor activities, all their other activities they would be undertaking are stripped out, and then news as well, if people wanting to stay up to date with what's happening in the disease. And then other ones to just shout out about are things such as in the business world, internet and telecoms, for example, law and government, business and industrial. These again are seeing really big increases in impressions as people start to work from home and look to different solutions to their everyday lives. The next thing we asked ourselves was, what has this done to the makeup of inventory and the devices which this inventory is on? What we're looking at here again is America and the trend for inventory changes throughout a month. You can quite clearly see the midweek peaks on desktop here, the line in blue, as when people go to work and desktop use increases and then falls away at the weekends. And again, you see across all devices, it's increasing as we go. On desktop, there's a 38% month-on-month increase, mobile 23%, tablet 19%. But if we compare this to the weekends, this is where we start to see something really interesting happen. So this is just looking at the weekends starting in February all the way to the end of March. And on desktop, we see a phenomenal increase of 112% in inventory. So this is telling us something about how people are using their devices now. Whilst desktop was normally confined to the office or working during the week, it's now being used even more on the weekends for that source of entertainment. It means that a consumer habit's changing and the way that they're interacting with that device is much different. You do see the increases, like I said, on mobile and tablet, but not as extreme. The one thing to say about this as well is it just means the things such as tenancy takeovers or any high impact formats that you're buying on a tenancy deal rather than CPM are going to start having much more value on the weekends, especially given that desktop is also a primary screen where it has your sole attention, compared to something like a smartphone or a tablet, which is traditionally a second screen as you do something such as watching the TV or commuting something else. So just outside of what happened to the inventory as well, we wanted to look at what happened the last time we saw a contraction in economies. So this was the thing that we thought was the most comparable to the current situation we find ourselves with advertising. And it's quite clear to see that COVID has created a global recession. We're starting to get the figures out now from the impact that it's had across global economies. I think we can all agree that we're in for a tough time economically for a few months, if not a couple of years. So what we wanted to do was look at, in the last recession, how did brands spend and how did that affect their recovery? So in this study that we found from Hiller in 2001, How to Prevent a Hangover, Brave Strategies for Difficult Times, we found that brands which cut their spend lost market share in the recovery period and also decreased their ROI during the recovery period. Those who maintained their spend saw a slight decrease in ROI and a slight decrease in market share. But then those who did increase their spend saw an even stronger recovery period and got a greater amount of market share. Now, we wanted to be thorough with this and we wanted to back this up from somewhere else. So our friends at Kantar have got these other figures that showed again, that brands who 60% of brands that stopped advertising during recessions saw a decline on at least one brand metric. So those who completely cut their advertising saw a 13% decrease in sales. And then those who halved their spends saw a 1% impact on their sales. But the one thing I think that's really worth pointing out about this crisis is that only 8% of consumers are expecting brands to cut their advertising. People still want to be advertised to. They still want to be seeing advertisements. They want brands to be carrying on as normal, if possible, and brands can continue to spend. So what makes this different from a normal recession is that it's been caused by a pandemic and not a financial crisis. So it's really unique in a way, because what has also happened is that we're combining this with something unique that's not been witnessed before, and that's an unprecedented increase in these advertising opportunities. There's lots more inventory now, which we don't normally get during a recession, and people are now on their devices a lot more and just working from home, maybe. And I did see this this quote from Ari, the Triple Lift co-founder, where he was talking about how he wrote a white paper on the effects of COVID. And in a nutshell, he's essentially saying there are more people online, but brands are spending less. So just to flesh that out a little bit more, what we are seeing is that reaching the same user now is cheaper. So supply is outweighing demand. There's much, much more inventory available, either from the excess or advertisers pulling back. And as I said, advertisers scaling back their spend, so there's less competition. And again, this is, we see it everywhere. This is YouTube. So looking in Spain, the closure of schools, the nationwide lockdown, you see the inventory increase, the CPMs fall. So in this case, in Spain, for example, impressions have decreased by 50%, which means it now requires 50% of the same budget to reach the same users. Sorry, 50% of the budget to reach the same users. And this is quite important when we think back to that study by Hiller, which was saying that brands who cut their spend during a recession lost market share, and those that increased their spend or maintained it managed to recover it much more strongly. In this scenario, you could easily halve your budget, but then still continue to have that strong recovery after this period is over. Another thing to point out with this as well is, if you are a performance marketing brand, you can start to offset your decreases in conversion rate by these decreases in CPMs as well. So if you had a 50% drop in conversion rate, and then you combine that with a 50% decrease in CPM, you get this maintained CPA, so you can mitigate the impact of the crisis that we're currently in. And then as well, if we again think back to that Hiller study, which said those brands who increased their investment during recession recovered even stronger and got more of a market share, this is now a unique opportunity in a way for brands who can afford to invest to increase that market share. So if you maintain your budget as it was pre-COVID, and with a 50% decrease in the cost of impressions, you've then got a potential double reach of a pre-COVID-19 campaign as well. So you don't have to be bold and start investing more at this time. There are tactics so you can continue to recover even stronger than before. But then just outside of that as well, you know, going back to what we saw about desktop usage, we wanted to have a look to see what impact this would have. So looking at other research, we've been able to see that desktop is the preferred device for the research and awareness stage for users who are over the age of 25. These are people who are using those devices to plan that next purchase, that next considered one, whether it be travel, retail, finance, anything like that. It is the device that people want to be advertised on that stage. And then, as I said as well, it's now people are spending more time on that device. It commands the solo focus of a user compared to something like a mobile phone. It means that the advertising on that device is going to have a much higher impact. And it's also kind of suggesting that the people who are on the device at these time on the weekends are likely to be looking at those future purchases. What is the first thing they're going to buy? What's that big purchase once the COVID crisis is over? Are they going to go for that holiday they've been thinking about, or that home move that they've put aside for a while? So it could be a crucial time to be engaging with these people. And then as well, you know, going back to what I said before, all categories are seeing users become more engaged, whether it be real estate, sports, travel, autos, shopping, everything that we think has been shut down. The users out there are still engaging with it in some way or another. Again, saying that they're wanting to see these advertisements and plan for these future purchases. And then this stat that we got from Integral Ad Science as well says that dwell time is going up on devices as well. So people are spending longer on these websites. So what's more, going back to my point about the value of tenancies earlier as well, whilst these tenancies are now more cost effective in reaching people, they're going to have more of an impact as well because they're staying on the screen for longer. So just another aspect to look at from this as well is we think what's going to happen when normality resumes. So when we come out of this crisis, when we go back to normal, what is going to happen? So what we wanted to do is compare this to, what we wanted to do is compare this to the situation now. So at the minute, inventory costs are low, inventory is high, and users are online and researching for that next big purchase. But what's going to happen is people are going to start resuming their normal lives. So whilst we've seen this massive increase in inventory at the minute, we're now going to see a big decrease when lockdown eases and inventory levels return to their normal selves, or even a bit lower as people want to have a bit of a digital detox after being stuck to their computer screens, the televisions and the games consoles. Other advertisers are going to start resuming spending as well. So those who did decide to pause or really pull back during this crisis are going to want to make up for that lost time. They're going to want to really start spending to get back onto their targets as much as possible. What this essentially means is that media is going to become more expensive and it's going to be harder to reach that target audience. We're going to see increased auction pressures. So CPMs are going to rise again, and any efficiencies that have been gained from your conversion rates increasing will be offset by that increase in the cost of the media. Just to say on this, what we are saying here is that if you can continue spending and spend in a very clever way, but one thing you've got to do is ensure that your tech stack will support this advertising that you're doing. And there's three things that you really need to make sure that you're doing all the time anyway, but especially through this crisis with sort of awareness tactics that we're talking of in the research ones. So first of all, you need a centralized tracking platform. All the activity that you're going to be doing, you want it in a central place, in a non-fragmented, connected measurement and consolidated view of reach and frequency across all users to really understand what your activity is doing. You want to be looking at data-driven attribution as well. So understanding the value of the upper funnel activity, making sure you're not going for that last click. As I said, users are in the research phase. They're looking for that next big purchase. You want to understand what it was that drove that intent for that user before it got to that bottom of the funnel conversion channel. And then finally as well, a robust data strategy, like this should be in place anyway, but at the minute you really need to ensure that you have a data strategy that allows you to reconnect with those valuable exposed users. So when inventory costs increase, you know who to talk to, know who is and isn't interested in your product, so you can make that conversion stronger, make that conversion rate stronger than the increase in the CPMs as well. Just as we come to the end of this, I just want to summarize what we've said today in our pieces of advice here. So why is now an ideal time to advertise and help us through this crisis? Well, inventory costs are abnormally low from the ever-increased impressions that we're seeing online and other advertisers scaling back. Users are more engaged with advertising, so they're wanting to be looking for that next purchase. They're researching what they're going to do after this. That brings me on to the third point. They are planning those post-COVID purchases. And the fourth, really is media costs will increase when the lockdown ends. So if you are planning on trying to make up for losses at the end of this period, it might be an idea to start investing now, even if it's at a small level, because of those costs increasing, it might pay off in the longer term. And then finally, I just want to say again, brands who did spend during recessions have had these stronger recoveries. There's multiple cases out there. You can find it yourselves fairly easy with a quick Google. It's not just Jellyfish saying this. So yeah, go out there and have a research into that. One of the things as well is Jellyfish, we talk about clients as partners and prospects as partners as well. And we'd love to help you solve your problems at this time, whether it be tech stack related, display strategy, paid media strategy, attribution, wherever we can help, we will. If you want to follow the link on the screen here, or if you get your phone out and look at the QR code here, that will take you to a Google web form where you'll be able to leave a few details behind what you'd like help with, or even specify in the other category if we've not mentioned something here, and we can get one of our account management team to get in touch with you and see how we can help out. So that brings me now on to the QA session. So if there's any questions at this point, my colleague Rowan will be asking the questions to me, and hopefully I'll be answering them for you.
Well, Thomas, the first one is, do we have any the same inventory trends that we looked at for Latin America, or is that something we might be able to get offline?
Sure. Yeah, so for the case of this study, we have looked at trends globally, and yes, we have seen the same things in Latin America. You see the starkest changes in countries which have locked down, but certainly you do see it across the board where people are more voluntarily working from home as well. We do have that information, but if you to get in touch, we can provide that information for you as well, especially if you tell us which Latin American countries you're interested in.
Okay, and the next one we have here, what are your interpretations for the construction market? That might be another one that we can collect offline, but I'll let you answer.
Yeah, so what we are seeing is a lot of interest, even in real estate and construction, that side of things in a few European countries, which we can use to take some insights from. We're seeing that as soon as lockdowns are lifted, real estate companies have been increasing the amount of listings for new and existing properties, and we are seeing massive increases in traffic to those websites, and we expect to see that in other countries. The one thing that we can say, and what we have noted, because countries entered lockdowns at different time and came out of them, we see the same trend country after country. I think with how global we are now, we all act in a very similar way. So the learnings we can take from one market can be applied to another. And one of the things that we can do, because we are a global one Jellyfish company, we can provide insights which one of our other offices have seen in a different location, and then apply that to a local market. So if you wanted to explore that further, we could get one of our teams to look into that for you.
Great. We have a follow-up to that question, then I'll jump to the next, but wondering about the sources for those inventory trends.
Yeah, sure. So those inventory trends come from 40 different ad exchanges. So we focus mainly on the Google AdX. I can't remember what it's called these days. They change the name very often. That comes from Google, Rubicon, AppNexus, PubMatic, I think of all the other big ones out there. Essentially, it's the major inventory sources, which cover about roughly 99% of inventory online. And what we can do is we can look at the past 30 days to see how inventory changed over time. So to see what was available for us to buy. And that's how we're able to observe these trends.
All right. So one of these questions is about skipping back to a different slide. So I'm just going to go to one more kind of on the same topic. Or we do that streamline. Are there any positive trends in the automotive space that you can speak to or share?
I'm assuming this means in terms of interest, in terms of traffic. So yes, we are actually seeing that in a few countries, that people are now starting to research more for those post-COVID purchases. And as we're starting to see more manufacturers begin manufacturing cars again as well, we start to see this increase in interest for automotive products as well, whether that be cars or aftercare products as well. What we can do is we can look at that on a brand by brand basis, and we can look into the trends of how that interest and intent is changing for different brands. One of the nice things that we can do as well is understand the opportunity to buy against a particular brand and plot that from when they start releasing positive PR stories about when they're going to restart their manufacturing or when their stores open again. So we can plot what would be the right time to start that awareness advertising again. So if we found out, for example, that it takes 7 days from seeing an advert for the new Ford to get someone to come into a showroom, we would then be able to infer a strategy, which was, right, your stores are opening again on June 3rd, so we need to start advertising on May 25th, for example.
All right, so wondering if we can circle back to the slide about why now is a good time to advertise. Maybe just hit on that again.
Okay, let me have a go. This one?
Yeah. So maybe if we could just walk through that, I think, one more time.
Cool. Okay, so yeah, just to cover this one off again, so why it's an ideal time to advertise at the minute. So inventory costs are extremely low. They're abnormally low. That is due to the unprecedented fact that we've got this massive increase, people locked in their homes, so more on their digital devices, and also that other advertisers have pulled back their advertising in some way or another, which means that the cost to advertise has decreased because there's less competition for inventory, simple supply and demand there. The second point was on how users are more engaged with the advertising. So we're inferring this from the fact that the dwell time on websites is increasing. The categories across the board are increasing. We're not seeing any negative growth in any category at all. And it's more on the desktop devices as well, which is primarily the research and the awareness device. So it's a good time to do that brand advertising. Third is as well that the users are planning their post-COVID purchases as well at this time. So what is that big thing they're hoping to do when this crisis is over? I know I've been looking at lots of holidays to the Caribbean. And then the fourth being that the media costs will increase when the lockdown ends. So if you are hoping to make up for lost time whilst you have been paused or pulling back on activity, it might not be the best approach because of the media costs going up and everyone else trying to do the same thing at once. If you can advertise now and have that correct data strategy in place to re-engage with those who you've exposed at this time, you'll be able to be much more successful when the lockdown ends. And then finally as well, just on that path research, and have a look at this research again. It's called How to Prevent a Hangover: Brand Strategies for Difficult Times. And that's got a lot of things in there about how advertisers who spent during recessions had stronger recoveries. And then there's also research from, they were called Millward Brown at the time, now called Kantar, about how brands who continued their investment during the 2008 financial crisis then had a much stronger recovery in the following years.
Is all the questions we've gotten. Are there any others anyone wants to drop into the chat box now? I think you've covered it all, Tom. Thank you so much.
No problem. And like I say, we're happy to help. I'll put that slide up again in case anyone wants to get in touch in the future has any other questions, and we'll get in touch with you as well, or you can follow up by email if you've got an account manager at Jellyfish.
Sorry to interrupt you. We did get one last one that I think might be interesting to cover now if you want to end on a high note. What would the analysis change be given a second wave of COVID-19, like we're hearing about for possibly the fall?
It's a good question. And we have been discussing this recently, actually. The one thing that we wouldn't know about a second wave is that going to change the behavior of consumers and how people act? So I think it's not the fact of the second wave of the disease. It's more of a, what will the government's respective government's responses be to that second wave? Will we see something where retailers stay open, that we can continue our lives, but in different ways? Or will we go back to the lockdown again? So depending on how we approach that could change on how we do our advertising again. It's hard to say for that, but what we would do is, again, we'd look at the research. And most likely what we'd do is, because we are led by our data, is we'd look at, during this first wave, how did advertisers perform? What were the strategies that worked? When the first wave was over, what did the recovery look like for our brands who acted in one way compared to the other? And then it's likely that we'd republish the research into that again so we could advise our clients. I wish I could tell you the future and how we would respond to that. I think the most hopeful thing to say on that is that there's not much of a second wave and that we go back to a more form of normality. Okay, so I think that's all in terms of questions. So as I said before, plugging it once more, scan the QR code if you want to get in touch further or follow the link. And I hope that's been useful to everyone. And thank you for joining us today, and make sure everyone stays safe during this time. Thanks.